OpenSilver 2.0 is here, and it's packed, absolutely packed, with over 100 new features that will supercharge web application development. We're talking VBNet support. For the first time, developers can use VBNet and XAML to build web applications. But there is so much more. Enjoy integration with frameworks like Blazor, Angular, and React, so you don't have to start from scratch if you already have an app. And development is super fast, with live XAML preview, allowing you to see your app without even running it. And one of the features that I missed the most from the Silverlight days is making a return. I'm talking about the Business Application Project Template. Powered by RIA Services, it lets you build huge, complex line of business applications very easily. We have also built a real-world example called Sample CRM to serve as your starting point. And that's just scratching the surface of what's new in OpenSilver 2.0. My favorite new feature, which is currently in preview, is really unique. Something never seen before in the .NET space. Be sure to stay until the end of the video to learn about it. I will also discuss the roadmap and the exciting new developments that are on the horizon. Hi, I'm Giovanni Albani, CEO of Userware. We have been working on OpenSilver for almost a decade now. The project began as a modern replacement for Microsoft Silverlight, evolving to support more and more elements from WPF, UWP, and WinUI. And now it has become a full-fledged SDK to build amazing web apps using .NET and XAML. OpenSilver is free and open source. It's distributed as a NuGet package, and you can download the Visual Studio extension from opensilver.net. OpenSilver has been used to migrate and modernize hundreds of apps. Here is an example. On the left, you can see the original Silverlight application running in Internet Explorer. On the right, it's the migrated OpenSilver application operating on Edge, Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and all modern browsers with no plugin required. Notice how the UI is pixel-perfect identical, so the end users don't notice the difference. And the performance is impressive too. We're talking about hundreds of thousands of lines of code with very complex controls like Telerik UI for Silverlight and RIA Services. There has been almost no rewrite, as more than 99% of the original code from the Silverlight version has been reused in the migrated one. But today we're here to discuss OpenSilver 2.0 and explore what's new in this freshly released version. Let's dive in, shall we? First up, VBNet support. OpenSilver welcomes the Visual Basic community. It provides a tool to build web applications using the language you love. Yes, Visual Basic paired with XAML. Here is how it works. Simply download and install the Visual Studio extension from opensilver.net, create a new project, choose empty OpenSilver application VBNet, and you're up and running. Whether you are creating a groundbreaking new web app or moving a legacy app to the modern web, we've got your back. You can see an example of VBNet application in our repository. It's named opensilver.samples.showcase. Next, frameworks integration. OpenSilver 2.0 works great with popular web frameworks like Angular and React. This means you can have apps that are partially crafted in Angular, for instance, and partially in OpenSilver. And hey, Blazor developers, we have something special for you too. We have recently introduced XAML for Blazor. It allows you to add OpenSilver to your Blazor WebAssembly projects easily and without starting from scratch. Here you can see an example where Razor files and XAML files coexist side by side in the same Blazor project. You can pass objects around, subscribe to XAML events from your Blazor code, and so much more. Learn more about it at xamlforblazor.com. Next up, one of my favorite features, live XAML preview. Imagine visualizing your application UI without even having to launch your app. With OpenSilver 2.0, you can see your UI as you work on the XAML code. No need to wait for compilation. Plus, you can interact with the preview and partially use your application right from within the Visual Studio editor. This not only makes building your app incredibly quick, but also marks the first step towards a future where you can construct your design with drag and drop. We're not there yet, but stay tuned for a future update of OpenSilver that will introduce a drag and drop designer. Alright friends, let's explore how you can accelerate your line of business application development with the return of the Business Application Project Template. And guess what? RIA Services, an old favorite from the Silverlight days, is back in OpenSilver 2.0. With RIA Services, you declare your entities on the server side, and it automatically generates client-side objects. This brings you a unique, easy-to-use entity framework experience right on the client side. Say goodbye to repeating yourself with redundant boilerplate code. RIA Services handles everything for you. Querying, validation, client-side entity caching, change tracking, batch updates, and so much more. This accelerates your development, enhances security, and most importantly, frees up more time for you to focus on the crucial aspect of your application, the business logic. And by the way, this works for C# and VB.NET, your choice. I can't resist showing you a demo. We're going to create a small line of business app, and we're doing it in less than 120 seconds. Ready for the challenge? Let's start the countdown. First, download the free sample database from Microsoft called AdventureWorks and restore it. Then, utilize the new cool business application project template that comes with OpenSilver 2.0. You can see that it creates both the client-side and the server-side projects. On the server side, click Add New Entity Data Model. Then, choose Designer from Database. We'll be using a database-first approach here, but feel free to use other approaches like code-first approach if you prefer. After connecting to the database with the connection string, you're greeted with this impressive table diagram synchronized with your database. Next, we'll select what to expose to the client side. For this demo, we just want to expose our list of customers. We click Add New Domain Service, choose Customers, click Enable Editing, and click OK. Everything can be customized with code, such as implementing security measures, limiting the data that can be queried, or applying constraints to entities, like regular expressions for email and password fields. Now, let's rebuild the solution, and RIA Services will automatically generate the client-side entities. From the client side, we can now run link queue queries directly on the entities. RIA Services is optimized so that the query is not executed on the client side. Instead, it's sent to the server side and even up to the database as a SQL query, ensuring only the entities we're seeking are retrieved. We simply add a data grid and a data form to display the entities. And there we have it. Pretty cool, right? With just a few more lines of code, you can make those entities editable. You can specify the constraints on the server side, and those constraints will automatically cascade down to the client side and even to the UI. As you can see here, the data form will display validation messages. How cool is that? We have put together a real-world example that you can find on our GitHub. It's called Sample CRM. This example features a sleek dark theme, and it uses SQLite, so there's no need to restore the database, though of course you can replace it with your own. Consider it as a potential jumping-off point for your upcoming projects. I won't go over all the features in OpenSilver 2.0 because there are more than 100, but I'd like to discuss a couple more, and then I will show you a sneak peek of what we're working on next. The layout engine has been completely revamped and is now identical to that of SQLite and other XAML technologies. This means you can create custom panels by overriding Measure and Arrange, and third-party libraries like Telerik UI for SQLite can now be recompiled to run with OpenSilver. The simulator is now up to 10 times faster. You may be wondering, what's the simulator, right? It's a fantastic tool included in OpenSilver that allows you to debug your application as though it were a desktop application. Rather than running in the browser using WebAssembly, the simulator runs your application using .NET Framework or .NET Core. This means you can utilize all the powerful debugging features of Visual Studio, such as shifting execution to a different line, running code in the immediate window, using profilers, or even leveraging third-party tools like .memory to easily find memory leaks in your application. The new version of the simulator is super fast. It really accelerates the development cycle. Be sure to check out the full changelog at the URL displayed on screen. Now, let's take a moment to discuss the roadmap, shall we? As I mentioned earlier, we are developing new tools like a drag-and-drop XAML designer. We are also crafting an entirely new documentation, which is expected to be ready in 2024. We are also integrating more and more features from WPF. As you know, SQLite was conceived as a subset of WPF, so now we are extending support to WPF-specific features. And we are working on support for Microsoft LightSwitch. Did you recall that secret new feature I hinted at the beginning of the video? It's showtime. The .NET ecosystem is full of frameworks. There are a lot of alternatives to create apps, but they all have something in common. They all let you create 2D, two-dimensional applications. Picture this. 50 years ago, applications were 1D, one dimension, essentially the command line. Then, the pointing devices, and especially the mouse, introduced us to the 2D, two-dimensional era. The early 2000s saw the advent of multi-touch through smartphones and tablets, reshaping the industry again. Today we stand on the brink of a new era. Some call it spatial computing, while others call it mixed reality or something else. Although it's in its early stages, it's expected to become mainstream in a few years. The attractive 2D interfaces of today will eventually appear obsolete, constrained arbitrarily to the restricted 2D surface of our monitors. Imagine the productivity gains if you could not only look at the software, but immerse yourself within the software. From simple conveniences like viewing thousands of data points simultaneously, perceiving distances on a genuine 3D globe instead of a flat one, crafting 3D charts, to rapidly sorting entities by physically grabbing and throwing them to categorize them like this, and more complex tasks like digital twins that offer an instantaneous overview of everything happening in an airport or a hospital through an immersive, semi-transparent model. The possibilities are boundless. Today we're thrilled to unveil a sneak peek of XRSharp, the 3D and AR-VR toolkit built atop OpenSilver, designed to reshape your software perception. What you are seeing here is an OpenSilver application running in a browser. This 3D calculator is crafted in XAML. This shows how you can seamlessly integrate 3D into your OpenSilver applications. Plus, if you have a virtual or augmented reality headset, by clicking Enter VR, you are transported inside the application, where you can grab the 3D calculator and interact with it using your hands. If your expertise lies in building 2D apps with XAML, we believe XRSharp is the most straightforward way to create 3D apps, because everything works identically. XAML, view models, all within Visual Studio. If you want to try it out, head over to xrsharp.io. On xrsharp.io, you will find this example application, and you can download the pre-alpha version of the extension for Visual Studio. No headset is required. You can begin by just creating 3D content for the web, and many more samples are coming. So, dear developers, OpenSilver 2.0 represents far more than an update. It's a giant leap forward, ensuring .NET and XAML continue to thrive in today's web development landscape. We are not just reviving, but transcending the spirit of Silverlight. From supporting VB.NET, integrating with popular frameworks, presenting a live XAML preview, easily crafting line-of-business apps with RIA Services and the Business Application Project Template, and exploring 3D and spatial computing. OpenSilver 2.0 is available for download right now at opensilver.net. On the website, you will also find information on our professional services, which include end-to-end migrations. I'm excited to invite you to dive into OpenSilver 2.0, explore its capabilities, and join us on this incredible journey toward crafting the future of web development. Thank you for embarking on this journey with us today. Until next time, happy coding.